This is Steve Toom reporting from SuperCon in Sioux Falls. One of the featured guests is author KT Webb. KT, thank you for joining us today. First of all, to someone who's not familiar with the work, how would you describe your style of writing and what kind of books that you write?
I am a young adult author, primarily. I write kind of superhero, supernatural type books. I also have some adult contemporary romance.
And where do you hail from?
I live in Watertown, South Dakota.
And how long have you been writing, and how many years has it been since your first book has been published?
Writing, I've been probably writing my whole life. Before that, you know, I just made stories up and didn't actually write them. But first book was published in 2014.
And what is your publishing company?
I am actually an independent author, so I do it through CreateSpace and Amazon.
And with the recent advances with people publishing, it's opened up a lot for independent authors who don't necessarily have to rely on the big publishing companies. Who got you started on that path, is pointing you in that particular direction?
A friend of mine, actually. Her name is Jess Miller. She writes under Jess Potosa, and she started doing her own publishing, and then I kind of finished a book, and I asked her about it, and I just kind of ran with it. I love it. It frees up my schedule. I'm in control of my own schedule. So.
And how many books have you had published?
I have five, technically. Two are novellas. So.
And what is the latest book that you've written?
The latest that came out is called Stay the Night. It is a adult contemporary romance, and I have one coming out in June 21st.
Are these part of a series, or are these standalone books?
The adult contemporaries are standalones, but they do have interconnecting characters, so they can be read on their own, or if you want to know more about some of the supporting characters, you can read the other books. The other that I have is a series, and then this new book that will be coming out in June is the first book in my next series.
So how would you describe your latest book? If somebody who's walking through a bookstore, how would you describe that book in brief?
The one that's about to come out, or the one that...
The one that's about to come out.
There's so much to it. I would say teenage girls who discover that they are the final witches in a long line of real witches, and they have to go on this crazy adventure and find all these little pieces that will help them piece together their future and their history.
Now, if you had to compare your books to a well-known published author, you know, along the lines of, who would you say that would be?
I've had people compare my first series to kind of like The Hunger Games, but it's not really, I don't personally see the connection. I love The Hunger Games, but a lot of people have described it that way. And then my new series that's coming out, there's these books called Wicked is the first book, and I would kind of compare them to that.
Now, there's been a lot of the urban fantasy books, Jim Butcher's books, shows like Supernatural on TV. Have those been an influence on you?
I would definitely say Supernatural. I love the show, and I've kind of incorporated some of the different creatures into my new book series.
I have some nieces that are a huge fan of Supernatural, so I know exactly where you're coming from on this. What other authors would you say have been influence you?
Well-known authors, I would say J.K. Rowling. I grew up reading Harry Potter, so that was a big one for me. Jasper Ford is an author from Great Britain, and he is amazing, and I love his books. But then I also have had some other independent authors who have inspired me. B.J. Sheldon, she kind of gave me that boost to get me going, and Liz Long.
How many conventions have you done, and how many do you plan on doing this year?
This year I have, this is my third convention, and then I have four more coming up.
So what do you see the future going down the road? Are you going to continue with some of the series, or do you plan on more standalone books?
Definitely series are kind of where my heart is. I do have a standalone fantasy coming out later this year. But that's my first complete standalone, and I'm really excited about it, but I'm also kind of thinking, what am I going to do if I want to keep the story going? So.
And if people want to find you online, where should they go?
Well, I have a website. It's ktwebauthor.com, or I'm also on Facebook under KT Webb.
Are your books available in local bookstores?
Not yet. I do have someone who will be starting a bookstore here actually in Sioux Falls, I will have my books there, but otherwise they can be found on Amazon.
Thank you for your time.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks.